Live, Tulsa's interim city attorney says he's not backing down, despite the council's vote of no confidence and requesting his resignation. 2 News reporter Beth Hawkins joins us live from Tulsa City Hall with more. Beth?
Russ, the council says that the interim city attorney is not doing his job properly, and because they're in a court battle of their own, they say they have no choice but to hire somebody else.
The council has no choice.
Councilor Rick Westcott says that the interim city attorney, David Pauling, received the vote of no confidence after they say he didn't show up for court on the council's behalf.
He doesn't make any sense at all. He contradicts himself. You know, first he says that we weren't properly served, and then he says that we were.
You don't show up unless you've been served. You don't go to court, you don't volunteer.
Pauling says there's also a conflict of interest because the court matter involves the position he now holds, and council is being sued for voting to make that position an elected one.
There is not another person that could have held the council accountable the way I have.
Mayor Dewey Bartlett stands by his new hire and says there needs to be some reflection time.
I know that there's a lot of emotions getting involved, people getting angry about this and that, and so I think it's in situations like that, it's better just to allow things to cool down a little bit, and then we can discuss it.
In the meantime, the council has a verbal agreement with another attorney.
We have to spend taxpayer funds because the city attorney won't represent us. So my question for Mr. Pauling is, what's keeping you here? Why are you fighting this?
Pauling says when it comes to other city business, he's not going anywhere unless told otherwise.
They've done everything they can to bully me, to humiliate me, and I certainly have a sense of fighting back.
And that resolution is now on the mayor's desk, and although the mayor says he doesn't have to take any action on it, he says he does plan to discuss the issue further with the council in 2 weeks. Reporting live from downtown Tulsa, Beth Hawkins, 2 News Works for You.